If you want to trigger an automation by pushing a button from your Airtable interface, then look no further than this video. I'm going to be going into two different examples, one of them relatively simple and one a little bit more complex, that will allow us to trigger automations directly from an Airtable interface button being pushed. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, where we help you save up to 20 hours of your time every week with no-code tools and automation. If that's of interest and you want to learn more about how you can start saving more time with automation, check out my free training. It's going to give you the fundamental building blocks so that you can start leveraging the power of automating data back and forth in the background so that you don't have to do it manually anymore. You can sign up for that training at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. I'll include those links below. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of this. We are talking about triggering an automation directly from an Airtable interface. Now, Airtable recently released the button feature inside of the Airtable interfaces, but the button does not actually trigger an action the way it would with a normal button that you can put directly inside of your Airtable database. The Airtable interface button is different in that what you can assign to it is editing specific fields within a very specific record that you've chosen for your interface. Now, this is very different from triggering an actual automation because automations can take action within other different software tools, and they can also write into different records inside of Airtable. The editable function of the interface button, by contrast, only allows you to perform actions on that specific Airtable record. So how can we use this as a trigger to initiate a large-scale automation? Hopping on into my database here, you'll see that I have an email title, a subject, a body, and some attachments. Now, I've also built this extra field called trigger. And inside this field, I'm going to put in some very specific text that will in turn trigger my automation. And I'm also bringing in a recipient email address here. So I'll go ahead and drop my own email address here. Copy and paste that down. And now we can start testing some automation emails from this. So I'm bringing in the subject, the body, and some attachments. And then I'm going to send that email upon hitting the button in my interface to the email address that I've put here. Now, of course, this is just one example of an automation. You can take this same framework that I'm showing you here and utilize it in your own automations. So the simple version is this. Switching into my interface that I've put together, you'll see that I have a record picker here in the upper left corner. So I can select a different record from a list. I've also added a condition here that states that that trigger field must be empty. Because once I have filled that trigger field, that means I've already taken action on this particular email and it has performed this function. I don't want it to show up here again. I don't want to accidentally push that button and think that I'm resending an email. So this is the record picker. Inside of the record picker, once I've selected a specific record to look at, in this case, email 2, then I see the other information that lives here. Here is the recipient email. I've made it editable. Here is the subject of that email. Again, I've made that editable. And here is the body, editable again. And also the attachments, also editable. So this way I can look at the framework of this email that I'm planning to send out before I send it out, make any changes because these fields are all editable, and then click that send email button. So what does that wind up doing? Well, I've set it up so that this will update one field. Namely, it's going to look at that trigger field that I built, and it is going to put in this little block of text. Let's get this party started, exclamation mark. This is going to then do two things. One, remove that email from my interface, because again, I've applied a filter here that won't let me see anything where the trigger has any text whatsoever. But the second thing that that will initiate, back in my Airtable setup, I've built version 1 of my simple automation. Here, my trigger is to simply look for a new record that matches these conditions. The trigger states, let's get this party started. Verbatim, it has to match the text that I have updated when I push that button. And what I'm able to do now is say, well, as soon as a record meets that very specific condition, then I want to take whatever actions I wanted to take. So there's a little bit of an extra step here, whereas the straightforward buttons that we can build directly inside of our Airtable database don't require this workaround. We have a simple two-step process that is going to slap some text in there, then an automation that's watching for that text to trigger the automation to do whatever I want. Now, in my particular case, I want to send email. So I'm going to send it through my Gmail account. I've mapped out my recipient email field. I've mapped out my subject, my message, and also my attachments here. And if we go ahead and make sure that this automation is flipped on, we can actually give it a test. So remember, we want to initiate this from our interface. So flipping back in here, I'm going to leave the edit mode and go to the interface itself. Once inside here, I can select the email from the list that I want to send. In this case, I haven't sent email to yet. I look, make sure that my email matches. Maybe I want to make a change here and add an emoji inside of my subject. So I'll bring in the cool guy with glasses, change the body if I want to, update my attachments. And when I'm ready to go, all I do is smash that send email button. Again, that's going to take a few actions. The first action is it removes that particular record from my dropdown here. It also moves me into the next record, which in this case is email 3. But we know as well that on the back end, that text just got dropped into my trigger field, which should then initiate my automation. So if I flip into my automation and I take a look, you see that it ran successfully. It sent out this Gmail, why is Airtable the best software, with cool smiley sunglass guy. And we see that the edits that we made on that record before submitting it took effect. If we flip into my Gmail, what we find is, yes, we received that email with the proper subject, the proper email body, and the proper attachment. So this is version one. This is the simple one if we're performing an automation directly inside of Airtable automations. But in version two, I want to show you how do we trigger this if we're using a third-party automation tool. Now, the reason that we might need to do this, of course, is Airtable automations are somewhat limited with the number of tools they connect to. So very often, in order to get access to all the different software that we can automate with, we need to step into a third-party tool. My tools of choice for this are either Zapier or Make. Make is the one I want to demonstrate for you in this particular video, but the steps I'm going to show you for this version 2 can be easily replicated for Zapier as well. Now, the best way to trigger an automation from a third-party automation tool is not to watch for records inside of Airtable. When we watch for records inside of Airtable to meet certain conditions, using third-party automation, it can take 5 to 15 minutes depending on the plan that you're on with that third-party tool. So it's way faster if we use a webhook. If we post directly to a webhook, we can get practically instantaneous automation triggers. So that's what I want to demonstrate here. Let's go ahead and pop into my automation inside of Make first. It's a simple three-step automation in this case. I've built my webhook here, which in this case is watch responses from Airtable. I'll show you exactly how to set that up. Then I'm going to go back and find everything there is to know about the record that we sent the ID through for. This will make sense in a moment. And then the last part of this is where I'm going to send out that email. So first and foremost, what is that webhook? Well, we set up the watch responses. We're going to add a brand new webhook here, and I'm going to call this email example. I'm going to save this up. And what this does is it provides us with an actual URL where we can copy this URL, and we're going to use this for our automation trigger. Now, let's flip on back to our Airtable database. Inside of our Airtable automations, we have a more advanced automation trigger. Now, for this one, what we're saying is the same trigger as last time. That is that once the phrase, "Let's get this party started!" exclamation mark shows up in my trigger field, this is identical to the last one. Well, now we want to run a script. And simply put, let's take a look at that script. We are going to simply say, let the URL equal, and this part right here is where we bring in and paste that webhook that we just created. Now, at the end of that, we have to append it with question mark, record ID equals, and here's where we're going to tell the script to watch for that record ID. We are going to find the record ID of the record that initiated the automation and send it, that record ID, to the webhook. Now, in order to do this, we have to also add an input variable. So I come over here and I have to name this variable exactly as I named it here because I'm defining this parameter. So I'm taking the name record ID, and syntax matters here, lowercase, capital letters, that all matters. I need to map this to the value of the record ID that triggered the automation. Let's go ahead and give this a test. and we're gonna get a success mark here. By the way, I will include these three lines of code in the description of this video so that you can just copy and paste it. And we're going to now see that yes, we received that record ID for the particular record that triggered the automation. Now I need to go back into Make and ensure that my webhook is properly finding that record ID. So if I right click on my first module and I run this module only, it is going to be looking. It's looking for something. So I can flip back into Airtable and I will test this one more time, and this will be sending that information to that webhook. When I come back here, you see that I got that green checkbox, everything is working fine, and the output from this particular step is that record ID. Now that's perfect because that is exactly what I need in the second step of my automation. So in this next module, clicking into here, I am getting a record from Airtable. So I have to map it to my Airtable connection, map it to the proper base and the proper table, and I need to map this to the record ID that I received in the previous step of the automation. So I simply come in here, I look at the previous step, all of the outputs that we got, and I need that record ID right here. I can drop that in and click OK. Now for the final step of the automation, I will actually send the email or whatever that action step is that you're doing. So one additional step for this more advanced use case where we're triggering from a webhook. Now in my final step, I'm going to send an email using Gmail. So of course I've linked my account here and I need to first know who the recipient of that is. Well, in this case, the recipient came from the previous step in the automation, which was when I looked up all the information about the email that I'm going to send through this automation. So that email recipient is going to be found right here. I can tag that in here. If I had multiple, I can add them as well. Here's where I'm going to bring in that subject. Here's where I'm going to bring in the body or the content of this. And if I wanted to add attachments, I could add them as well. Let's go ahead and skip that for now and just make sure that we can wrap this up. Before moving on, I need to be sure to save my automation. And I will now test it. Let's go back into Airtable. Let's make sure that our make automation is the one that's performing now. So I'm going to turn on my more advanced trigger here. I'm going to go back to my previous automation, the simple version, make sure this one's turned off, and now go back to my interface. Here I am on the third email. Let's suppose I wanted to add an emoji here of a rocket, plop that in, and I'm going to send the email. There's a lot happening behind the scenes, as we know. The first step is that this information is going to get updated right here with the push of that button. We are simply editing what belongs in that field, and we're entering in, let's get this party started. Once that's done, that is going to trigger this automation because that record will have met those conditions. And so you see that it successfully ran. A new record met those conditions, and then it performed this script which sent that information, that record ID, into Make. Now I always do this, I always forget to actually turn on my automation. So I'm gonna click OK here and tell it, yes, I wanna process the existing queue. And that automation is going to be sent in the background, and now our automation is turned on. Flipping now into my email, we see that yes, we did receive that. Of course, I did not properly map the attachment to be included with this email, but here's the body of the email, and you even see the new emoji in the title that I included before hitting that button. I know there was a lot to unpack here, but this is super powerful stuff, and it is going to help you build more efficient automations that trigger better and faster, and you can do it all from that Airtable interface. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. If you did, please be sure to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to this channel so that you don't miss out on future no-code videos, and I will see you in the next one.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program, and for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.